What's up, YouTube? Today I'm going to be doing a simple recipe for some barbecue chicken style shawarma on the grill, rotisserie. So let's get started. The advantage of doing this is on rotisserie style out there is it's really low maintenance. Once you get everything on the spit and you get it set up, you just kind of go out there and spritz from time to time with flavor and just let it cook. I'm using boneless chicken thighs, and I'm also adding in thin cut pork chops just to add a little bit more flavor to the shawarma. The night before season this up, I used a basic barbecue seasoning, which is my salt, pepper, garlic, paprika, onion powder, a little bit of cayenne powder, and brown sugar. I put all this stuff on here with a little bit of olive oil, mix it all up in there, and let it marinate overnight. And you can see you just end up with a whole bunch of this prepped meat beforehand. Flavor gets sucked right down in there because it just sits in those juices and it sits in those seasonings overnight. I don't think it really matters critically how you get this stuff on. The key is you want to pack it tight. There's little bits that will fall out. So this first cap piece, some people will put a piece of onion on here. I'm just not doing that right now. But this first cap piece is important, because what you want to make sure is that when it's rotating, it's kind of one big loaf. And that's the whole technique for this, is just kind of cooking everything. Even though it's small pieces of meat, you're cooking it as if it was one large piece of meat. This is great for parties. You're gonna have a lot. It's very flavorful. Keeps in the oven well. Season up their shawarmas however they want. They use barbecue sauce, mustard, A1, if they want to. I don't know, some people put A1 on chicken. I do not. I'm just trying to make sure little bits like this, there's not a lot of those, because those will char. So all you really gotta do once you get this loaf built, and I'll show you, is tuck those bits in so when it's rotating, it's all kind of one big loaf. It's built pretty good. Now we're gonna put the second half of the cage on and just try and trap as much of this top part as we can, and then really compress this tight together to make sure that this loaf stays solid when it cooks. You want to be prepared because this loaf is going to get smaller. This is a pretty good loaf, as you see. There's not a whole lot hanging off, a couple of small pieces. Last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to jam this just a little bit tighter. I'm going to cook this thing on rotisserie at 300 degrees for about 3 hours. Spritz it with juices as you see fit for flavor. I am probably going to be spritzing this with a little bit of apple juice and apple cider vinegar. I found that that tang goes great with the barbecue rub that I've made. Now we're gonna leave this guy to cook on this rotisserie, get our temperature leveled off at 300 degrees, come out here in a little bit, start spritzing this with juices. So this is the stuff I was talking about. You just kind of tuck these pieces as they reveal themselves, just to make sure they don't get too burnt. The nice thing about shawarma, or about cooking like this, is even the pieces that get a little bit of char, it's barbecue. It just adds to the flavor. I've been cooking for just about 30 minutes now. I'm gonna poke my head out here, give this thing a peek, bring you guys with me. Yeah. If they invent smell-o-vision, I'll make sure I add it to my channel, because already this is starting to smell delicious. Nice thing about the rotisserie and why I like doing it out here on the grill is the drips of the oil and the grease that flare up that smoke, it just adds magic to your cook. I mean, that's science. So you see, it's right now, it's really, really moist right now. It's starting to render out the fat, which is exactly what I want. I'm not gonna hit it with any applesauce or any flavorings right now. I'm gonna continue to just let it cook as it is. Now I've got this Evo oil sprayer. I got this off of Amazon. These things are awesome. They make this plastic one. They also make a stainless steel one that I keep under my grill for spraying this with the olive oil when I spray it down. These things are great at spraying thick fluids, and that's the key, because most of you guys know barbecuing, if you're spraying with normal sprayers, they usually get clogged and gunked anytime you're trying to use anything with oil or honey or any thick substance in it. These, not so much. Not only do they spray thick fluids well, but they spray a lot. I'll show you guys here. And I'll put a link to this down in the description, because I love these things. Starting to get that nice charred bits there on these tips. And all I'm doing now is just gonna keep almost basting, basting with. But we are looking good. Let that guy keep cooking. Come out here and spritz it as need be. The ratios on this, guys, pretty simple. It's mostly apple juice for this because I don't want it too tangy. But mix in the apple juice, mix in the apple cider vinegar, and taste a little bit. 2 hours into the cook, it's time for a temp check and another spritz. Yeah, we're at 140s down there in the core. Smells fantastic. When you cut this, you want to cut it all off and mix it so that the flavors blend in the chicken and the pork. Now we got pork chops in here, so I am going to cook this to 160. It's time to pull this chicken shawarma, cut up some sandwiches. This guy's been resting for about 15 minutes. I'm gonna go ahead and pull it off the spit and start carving it up. I've also got some pitas in the oven, got those warming up. After that, it's up to the user, dealer's choice. I've got cherry barbecue sauce, regular barbecue sauce. Some people even like putting ranch because it is chicken.
Look at daddy man.
Whoa. Yummy chicken.
How I'm gonna do mine. I like this barbecue shawarma with a little bit of barbecue sauce. Fantastic. Yeah, that hits the spot. Thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Go ahead and hit that like and subscribe and the notification bell for when I drop more videos. And enjoy some barbecue chicken shawarma.